Dugout News YouTube channel, welcome aboard once again. Hey guys, we're talking boxing, and yes, I got some new news for you concerning Deontay Wilder, Gerald Anderson, or Gerald Big Baby Anderson, and Martin Bokole. Deontay Wilder has been replaced by the most avoided heavyweight in quotes, on that Terence Bud Crawford undercard. We all know that Terence Bud Crawford will be fighting Israel Madrimov on August 3rd, but Deontay Wilder will no longer be competing on that card. Saudi boxing chief Turki Alalshikh was lining up a fight between a all-American affair fight between Deontay Wilder and Gerald Anderson in Los Angeles, provided Deontay Wilder had defeated Zhilei Big Bang Zhang, but that will no longer be the case. So the Bronze Bomber, we all know that he was knocked out in the 15th round by Zhilei Zhang last weekend, spelling an end to Turki Alalshikh's plans. It now seems highly likely that Deontay Wilder will hang up his gloves after admitting before the fight that a defeat could spell the end of his career. We've been carrying stories of what is up next for Deontay Wilder, his manager Shelley Thinkell having his thoughts and saying that we'll have a talk with Deontay Wilder and tell him what he thinks. We've had an insider in the Deontay Wilder camp saying that he might not hang up his gloves yet. He still feels that Deontay Wilder has something still to prove. But one man is loss is another man is gain, and Martin Bokole has now been given the call to face Gerald Anderson instead. The Congolese boxer has been steadily climbing up the heavyweight rankings after falling to defeat for the first and only time in his 21-fight career against Michael Hunter in 2018. He has a career record so far of 20 fights, one loss. That is the loss to Michael Hunter. Bokore recently recorded a career-best win against former world title challenger Carlos Takam in October. However, he has struggled to land a big fight since. He was in negotiations to face Joe Joyce next, but according to his trainer and manager Billy Nelson, the juggernaut pulled out of the fight to pursue a domestic dust-up with Derek Chisora on July 27th. As expected, Joe Joyce has pulled out of his arranged fight with Martin Bokole to fight Chisora, Nelson wrote on X. For a man who claimed he crippled Martin Bokore with body shots, you'd think he would gladly fight him. When you talk shit, you need to back it up. Didn't fancy not sleeping for another 9 weeks. The difficulty of finding a fight for Bokore has led to his promoter Ben Shalom branding him the most avoided heavyweight on the planet. Martin Bokole is the most avoided man in the glamour division and can beat every heavyweight on the planet on his day, he wrote on his exclusive TalkSport column. The Congolese puncher is an incredibly dangerous fight for anyone at his weight. He has all the physical attributes needed to reach the top of the sport. His stamina is excellent. He's extremely strong. And on top of all of that, he is a very good boxer. It's only a matter of time before he will be dining at the top table with the likes of Anthony Joshua, Tyson Fury, and Alexander Usyk. His next outing against Anderson will prove whether Bokole is really as good as Shalom suggests. Anderson, 17 fights, no losses, is one of the most exciting young up-and-coming heavyweights in the world right now. A number of media outlets have branded him a heavyweight world champion in waiting, while Tyson Fury, who has sparred with Anderson several times, is tipping him as the heir to his throne. I don't know what throne it is, because currently Alexander Usyk is the undisputed heavyweight champion. But if Bokore can't derail the hype train, then he will find himself in a very strong position to challenge for world titles down the line. We've heard of that several times, of Martin Bokore being avoided, and Martin Bokore is one of the guys that speaks so much against the British heavyweights. He's been saying that he's being avoided by all the British heavyweights in there. He's talked of Joe Joyce, a guy that they were in some kind of spat a couple of months back. Joe Joyce releasing some sparring photos showing Martin Bokore vomiting, things like that, and claiming that that was a result of those huge body shots. And the Martin Bokore camp also releasing some footage showing Martin Bokore trying to knock Joe Joyce's head off that neck. So there's been so much going on, and Martin Bokore also claiming that he's been avoided by all British top heavyweights, Dillian White, Anthony Joshua, Derek Chisora, name them. So with a chance at Gerald Anderson, a guy that he's looked at as a major prospect and a world champion in waiting, you think if he can go in there and beat up on Gerald Anderson, then he would have made a statement for himself. The guy is undefeated, and for God's sake, so many people have been throwing all kind of prizes for him. So if he can go in there, put up a very good performance against the guy that is held as a champion in waiting, then just maybe we can see him in those big fights, like Ben Sharom, his manager, does allude to. But for Gerald Anderson, Jared Anderson, a guy that he's known as the real big baby, because there's also Gerald Mira, who calls himself big baby. And so you're thinking that Gerald Anderson has to prove that tagline that he moves with, that moniker of a world champion in waiting. He did put up quite an average performance against Riyad Mahr in April. That was 13th April 2024 this year. He retained his WBC and WBO international heavyweight titles in that fight. He has been in fights with Charles Martin. Still not a convincing result there, considering that Charles Martin, though a former champion, but he's since fallen on hard times, had various losses, including that devastating loss to Luis Ortiz. He didn't look anywhere near good in that fight. Luis Ortiz knocking him out in that sixth round. So he hasn't looked good. And for Jared Anderson coming into that fight and winning it just via unanimous decision, you're thinking, what is this guy doing? This is a guy that has been knocked out by most of the guys. Anthony Joshua did knock him out in that second round. So you should be worried for Gerald Anderson. It is a huge test, even maybe more a test than it would have been with Deontay Wilder, because this Deontay Wilder version, he is tentative. He doesn't want to let his hands go. And you thinking Martin Bokore has been searching for this opportunity. If he can't put up a good performance against Gerald Anderson, maybe knocks him out or wins via unanimous decision. Martin Bokore is a guy that talks a lot. He's been talking of getting a chance at Zhilei Zhang, maybe in that China homecoming. He's talked of how he knocked down Alexander Usyk in sparring. You see, the guy is quite someone, a good talker in his own right. So he's in a big test, just as Gerald Anderson is. But we'll wait and see how that pans out. What do you think of this fight between Gerald Anderson and Martin Bokole? Turki Alalshikh had expected Deontay Wilder to be the guy to face Gerald Anderson, but because of that loss to Zhilei Zhang, that's why Martin Bokole does come in. What do you think of all this? Place your comment in the comment section below, and please subscribe if you're yet to subscribe. I sign out. Peace.